Hello, and welcome back to Let's Play Dot Hack Infection. I am Super Kite! I mean, Jack of All Trades. So, you guys are probably looking down there at the bottom right, left, I said left, and you guys are seeing, oh hey, when the hell did you get 9,999 HP and 999 SP, and when did you become level 99 with maxed out stats? Well, when I had to replay through the game, it would have taken way too long for me to play through it normally, so I did use cheats, and those cheats are going to carry on through these next, like, this next video, because I'm gonna knock out everything that I was going to do in the last two videos in this one video. So, let's go ahead and hop into this area revealed to us by Linda. We got this area in the last video. also, I have just every virus core in the game because it, why not? And again, this is the only instance of doing this that I am going to do because I don't want to rely on, I don't want to really rely on cheating. The only reason I did it this time is because, and as I said, I am, of course, you know, I wanted to get back to where I was, and, I said in my little update video of what's been going on in my life, what's actually been happening. So let's go ahead and use a speed charm on ourselves, and we are going to make a mad dash. Also, if you guys recall in the last video, I got the time bangles and whatnot. I didn't bother doing that for the save file because it doesn't really matter. They're in my main file, which is all I truly care about. Let's go into the dungeon! But they are, I don't really care too terribly much about getting the time bangles in, or the time armor in this one. There's no real point. You guys will see me using that, at a later date. But let's go ahead, Fairy's Orb up, and, yeah. I will one-shot everything. What? Why can't I move? I couldn't move for a second there, and I'm unsure why. Yeah, I'm actually, like, really kind of mad at myself for this, for what happened. Which, to be fair, wasn't 100% my fault. But at the same time, I should have had a backup save, which I now do. Now I actually have backups for everything I'm going to be doing moving here on out. For when I go to like do recording session, I'll be able to just hop into this, hop into the recording session, and that'll be that. But yeah, so. Dot hack, it's been a little bit, and I'm actually like really kind of sad I've been away for this long from dot hack, but I guess that's kind of part of it. Come on, Fairy's Orb, I'm going this way. Yeah, so hopefully you guys will understand why I'm using cheat codes, or why I did cheat to get my file back here, because I couldn't bring myself to play through this entire game again, dude. I couldn't do it. Like, as close to playing it as I did, I could not do it. Let's go in Fairy's Orb again, and we are at the end of this dungeon, and the video's not even remotely close to done, because I'm putting two videos worth of shit in this video. I'm not sure why I have a regen factor. It's because they're hitting me with skills that shouldn't be useful. I don't know. Either way, here's a cutscene coming up, so I will be quiet.
What is this place? The room. It's gone. It's like someone gouged everything that was here. No use staying here. I should head back.
Of all the rooms in this game, this one has to be one of my favorites. In this game, of course, there are actually some really interesting rooms in these games. So I'm actually going to go ahead and log out real quick, because I believe there's an email waiting for me by good old B. Rose, because she's doing her investigation stuff. And yeah, hey, look, she found a clue. Alf's friend, I'm meeting up with Meg at Theta, Great Distant Fertile Land, so why don't you come as well? Let's pray there's something. All right, yeah, let's go ahead and hop over there. So while Kite is super Kite, no one else is actually max level. I'm not joking. Kite is the only one who's level 99. Everyone else was just kind of like, I'll let them die if they die. I will go ahead and actually get a lot more fairies orbs, because I feel like I'm going to want those in this game. Also, I didn't bother getting Sanjuro and Natsume, because they don't really contribute much to the story. But, yeah, I get it, man. I don't really need to buy a lot. I also have max gold, because why not? I want it max gold. And I guess I'll get, like, I don't know, 20 of these, and, yeah. I guess, like, I'll have 50 total Mage of Souls. Yeah, that'll do. But again, don't worry, after I finish what I was going to finish in this episode, I'm not really going to be using this file anymore, so you guys should have no worries about that. If I use this file for anything, it'll be I fucked up again, and then I needed to go ahead and, oh, hi.
I'm going to Theta, Great Distant Fertile Land.
Well, you better hope it's not protected. But, yeah, it's only if I really mess up. Also, they're, like, level 18, because that's the natural level progression they all get. Which, again, is something I love about this game. So let's go ahead and head to the word list, and this is a level 23 area. I'm just a tad overleveled for this. I'd like to say I'm a tad overleveled, but, yeah. I will say, though, in the next two videos, we're gonna be done with this game, and that's gonna be awesome. I'm excited to be done with this game. You guys, like, have no idea.
I'll meet you in the deepest level of the dungeon, okay?
See, I'm going to say something right now. When I first saw this message pop up on the screen, my first initial thought was, holy shit, Black Rose is about to abandon us, and we're going to have to go with whatever other party member we brought, which, for me, was always another Wave Master. And then I would just sit there and basically, like, shit my pants, because, like, I don't want to go through a level 23 dungeon on my own. Screw that. That being said, I'm going to go ahead and speed charm. Because I want a speed charm, and screw Black Rose. Again, if she dies, she dies. I don't play this way normally. I'm only doing this so I can get back to where I was. I'll try and keep her alive, though. It'll be kind of hard for her to die, you know, because after all, I am going to be, one-shotting everything. Which is so weird. But, yeah, no, I'm actually going to be finishing this game in the next, two videos. And then the extra video will be the extra dungeon. I'm not really going to show too terribly much in regards to, oh no, she's going to attack me. Black Rose, stop it. Black Rose, I said stop. Stop hitting me. You're not going to, but stop. What was I saying? Oh yeah, no, so Dot Hack will be done in the next two videos. I'll have the extra video showing off the extra dungeon. I'm not really going to show off the grunty stuff. If you guys really want to see it, I'll show it all off at the end of the fourth game. Because why not? And that way I'll be able to show off literally everything grunty related. And I'm probably not going to show off all the Book of 1000 stuff until, again, the fourth game. I'm going to assume we have to go up. Oh no. Oh my god, I didn't one-shot something. What the hell are you? What are you? My god. I don't really need this. Let's go up here and collect our prize, which is... Oh, wait, no. Also, in the extra video, I'm going to be showing off all the goblin tag. So that's another thing. But, yeah, let's go in here for another cutscene.
Hey, here she is! Hello. Meg, what's the name of the area Alf went to? Forget about it. Huh? What do you mean by that? I just posted the keywords to that area on the board, but it seems to be dangerous. I'm sorry. Hey, wait! Stop! She's gone. But you heard what she said.
Yeah, the board.
Also, I understand seeing the name Super Kite would probably kind of ruin some of the things happening in the game. But oh well. I'm going to go ahead and before I leave, I'm going to go ahead and do Gardenia's dungeon as well because she invited us to an area. And I want to go do her dungeon because that's the last real thing I have to do in this game. Yeah, that's really it. After this, we're in endgame, peeps, and we're going, and it's gonna be law. It's gonna be awesome. It's gonna be so cool.
So, what's in here?
I don't know. Stuff? A treasure chest?
Do you think a Hitori Shizuka would grow here?
I think that's a flower.
That's what you're looking for? I hope you can find it.
Not here. It blossoms, then falls quietly on the mountainsides.
I like Gardenia. I actually, because I didn't get to talk about it much prior.
You're a real romantic, Gardenia.
I really like Gardenia. I think Gardenia is a really a cool character. I don't like her though. I definitely think there are better characters, but for what she is, for her type of character, I like her, because she is just this enigmatic person who just, she seems to really enjoy flowers. I mean, it's in her name. Her name is Gardenia, and she's really kind of like poetic in an odd sense, and I absolutely love that about Gardenia. But of course, not everyone feels the same way about it that I do. But I think Gardenia is a really, really cool character.
When I see the fluffy head of a dandelion, a thought always crosses my mind.
Like it would feel good if you could fly like that?
And Kite is also trying to be poetic.
No. I think it would itch when the fluff got in your ears.
Again, Gardenia, great character. Kite doesn't understand, but he's not a poet. Let's go in Fairy's Orb up. I'm not going to use a speed charm through this dungeon because there's no real point. The speed charms have kind of made these dungeons very... Don't stop it. Stop it. You're not going to kill me. You're not. Stop. I will one-shot you, though. Okay, you will almost one-shot my party members, though. God. But as I was saying, though, I do really enjoy Gardenia as a character. I like her more than some of the other characters or optional party members you get in this game. Because just remember, Gardenia is a completely optional party member. She is 100% optional. We don't need her in our party, and she is just like, we could go the entire game without getting her. So for this game, she's my favorite optional party member by far. I really enjoy Gardenia. That's not to say she's my favorite optional party member in this game. No, no, no. That goes to Sanjuro, actually. Sanjuro is my favorite optional party member because he's a He's a samurai. He's cool as hell, dude. Stop it! Stop. Maybe I will speed charm because these things are running away just a little too fast for my liking. And I don't want things to run away from me. Because that's not bueno. But other than like Gardenia, I really love Sandra. I think Sandra is a great character. Also, here are the things that can bring things back. I absolutely hate them. In later games, we will be running into enemies that can bring other enemies back. Like, just all the time. There will be more instances of enemies that can bring other enemies back. And I hate it. But monsters use the same rules that we do when we're brought back. Once we're brought back, we don't have any SP, so they can't bring any other enemies back once we kill them, which I think is great. Which is why I'm not really too concerned, because I can just one-shot things right now. Later on, when I'm actually back on my normal profile, I won't be feeling this exact same way at all. But here's a treasure chest. We got the Graceful Book, the Silver Scarab, and another Silver Scarab.
Did you ask me to come along so I could find this item?
And that's another thing. Gardenia does care. She's just a little tsundere. That's all.
You think too much. Let's go back.
Okay. And again, Gardenia is a tsundere character. She is just like, she cares. Or she likes you, but she doesn't want you to know she likes you. And that, I think, is actually kind of funny in her character. And that's another reason I love her character. Like, I love every character in this series for one reason or another. I do like Natsume for the fact that she's just, you know, she's eccentric. She's really, not even eccentric. Eccentric isn't the right word. I'm going to go and log out, though. It's not that she's eccentric. It's that Natsume is... She's ditzy, I guess. That's the best word I can say for her. Also, elf. That message was deleted. Of course it got deleted. Also, here's a thread all about our buddy Orca. Basically, because Orca is such a good guy in the game. He's such a well-known player that everyone knows him. Everyone knows that Orca is just a really cool guy, and he helps, I'm trying to think, he helps new players, and that's such a really cool thing. And even in Dot Hack Sign, the anime that predates this, he was a fairly, he was a fairly well-known person. Like, you hear about him even in that. God dang it, Kite. Huh? Message deleted. What, screaming conspiracy. Yeah, that is a little odd that message was deleted that had the area word. I assume, though, the area was protected anyway, so normal players, they couldn't get in. I guess let's go ahead and log back in and see what happens. It's just a little odd that after all of that, that area is protected, or that area, that message was deleted. Oh, well, I guess I should probably just go and log out and head back to the desktop. Maybe there'll be another email waiting for us. Who knows? Oh, hey. Dear Super Kite, this is the deleted post. Chosen, hopeless nothingness. He said he saw a girl and a guy with a red wand playing tag. I received an email from Alf's family which said he slipped into a coma while playing this game. And apparently the data volume is increasing in Chosen Hopeless Nothingness. Apparently some things are going down. And that thing with a red wand is there. Also, Aura messaged us again. That's a thing. Again, I sort of kind of can read that message, but there are some spoilers in it, so I don't really want to read it, so I'm not going to read it. But let's go ahead and hop back into the game in the Highland City of Dunleorig. Dunloriag? I don't know.
Where are you going without me?
KITE is on a mission right now. He knows that the thing that killed Orca is at this area. He knows the thing that put Orca into a coma is in this area. He knows that if he goes here, he can find this thing. KITE isn't thinking straight at the same time.
It might be there.
You mean Pennywise? Oh, well. But yeah, KITE isn't thinking very well. He's thinking with his emotions and not with his head. He just wants revenge right now. He wants to beat this thing, to defeat this enemy, and to hopefully save his friend. Black Rose knows what's going on.
The bastard that got Yasuhiko.
So you're gonna defeat it?
That's essentially the plan, to go in there against all odds and defeat this enemy.
I don't know if I'm strong enough to do it.
But we have to be. To be fair though, this thing, whatever it is with the red wand, did beat Orca. Not only did he beat Orca, he demolished Orca. Orca didn't stand a chance. Truthfully, what can we do? I mean, there really isn't much.
You have to. I'm going with you.
And Black Rose, fearing for our lives and fearing for our safety, wants to go with us.
Don't even try to stop me.
That determination is what I applaud in this game. But that's it for this video. Join me next time when I, Black Rose, and another party member go to this area word. And, well, fight whatever is there, whether it be the thing with the red wand or what. But I'll see you guys in the next video. My name is Jack of All Trades. Till next time, take care.